Good morning. I rebooted my two systems, the host as well as the guest. I did made some changes which are pretty much unrelated. Basically, there was a fix in Lib4D which enables me now to start the guests without root privileges. I'm using my second network interface card. I forward that to the guest so that the guest has dedicated access to the network interface. And previously that needed roots and full capabilities to the guest, so that sucks majorly. But now that's fixed, now I can basically run the guest with the QMU user ID and I can drop every capability. So that's nice. And another difference was that some change I made was I read some blog post about how the Spice was running in a network mode, so to speak, by default, and how you might be able to improve the quality or the performance of Spice in lo on local systems. So I basically made that adjustment as well, so might actually notice that a little bit or not, I'm not sure. But anyway, so I basically rebooted both machines, and although I have logged in via SSH, the guest is now pretty clean. I cleaned up the home directories for a large part and the temp and stuff like that. And so it should be pretty clean. So we can basically this is on the host. This is on the client or on the guest, and let's see if we can search AVCTS today if there's any significant AVC denials added to allow. Takes a while, and those aren't related. So, although there were some AVC denials where named cannot write to named.conf-t, which is a bug in what's that program called? Well, it's some DNS thingy for DNSSEC, but it should be fixed in that package and not in the policy. And that LXCnet wants to write to RPM for libtdirs, and not sure what that is, but it's with regard to my container. I have a container also running in that guest. And wants to basically add something to RPM for libt, I guess, or either that or check RPM for libt, or maybe it's just a leak, not sure what it is. But anyway, it's not important, not related. So we have this clean setup, we rebooted, we cleared the directory. Let's just log in, see if that's possible. So we're in enforcing mode. Get enforce. We're enforcing. So let's just log in and see if that still works. See if anything has changed. Now we have a security alert. Let's have a look and see what that is. So, let's deal with these. Let's just make these a little bit more, and then just less chew them. See what's happening. So we have FuzzyD doing a module request. here. So let's, well, I'll be damned. Nano, my login user, TE, and then see if we can GVFSD Fuzzy. Yeah, that's nice. And then where it's self signal here. Let's just damn. And let's just get rid of this. I don't need this. I don't need this either. Although that might just kill my shell. Module request, and that's a kernel system. Okay, so we are going to need to require some stuff here. So kernel T. System. It's still early, so you know that I'm going to make stupid typos again. Module request. Let's just require that class and permission. Require class system module request. Alright, so we took care of this one. Here we have settings writing to user home dirty. And let's just see what I gset data convert actually. So where is gset data convert? Is it gset? Nah, it's not gset d data convert, is it? No. So that sucks. I should really fix that. So I'll just do this now manually, and then I'll try to fix that. Gset data convert like that, so that it's more intuitive. So let's see. I don't actually have any rules here with regard to that. So let me just add this one. So it's a write, and then we'll see later what's that all about. On a dir, use home dirty, trying to write something. Now I'll just add a fix me, so that I can grab fix me later. Not sure what it wants. And here we have spice, basically a string connecting to or VDA agent. So where is VDA agent? VDA agent, and I'll just, yeah, VDA agent. So let's see if we have anything related already. This is kind of related. So it's sock file. and it's trying to write to it. Right. Right? Right. So here it's going all nuts. Can't write. She's going all the way crazy here. But that's basically all we have right now. We have this one here. TR store. So let's just grab the TR store. Also doesn't actually tell us much. It's just writing to config there. So let's go to TR store. Grab TR store. And so it's writing to config there. So that's basically, let's just copy this over and change that a bit. This is basically TR store writing, right, to config home tiders. Okay, that should basically be it. Make f user share as a Linux devel make file as a module I, and then it's my login user pp and my xdm pp. Load that into the system. And then just log out, if that's possible. It seems to be a little bit snappier. Not sure if I really notice it. Maybe it's just wishful thinking. Kill all you, and then we're killing my login user processes, and then we're clear my login user shell to clear the processes there. Ls all z home my login user to check it out. We're clear, and then basically ls all z temp. See, yeah, we need to basically rm rf temp, and then remove that my login user pools file so that we can be sure that that's clean. Ls all z run user just to make sure that we're clean. Run user, and we're clean there. Hopefully a little bit quick. Usually I just focus on my screencast, but this question might All right, so hopefully this will take care of that. So we're about to log in again, aren't we? Yeah, we are. My login user. And let's see if we're at 909. See if we have anything new. Well, and I'll just take aughts. Actually, I'll just take 9 o'clock. Actually, I'll just take today. G. Just to be sure. That's basically all. But we do have. Might be something that is dunk audited. Alright, here it's stream connecting. So let's just add that as well. These are related, so I'll just feed the agent. Also required a type. That's basically all it is for now. But as a module. DB in the meanwhile. Okay, we did that. Let's just save this. Although, might actually. Need to. Actually build. Log out again when it's done. It's done. Yeah, it's a little bit snappier, the interface. I think. Still not, because you always see that when just when I say it. There's some obvious All right. So let's just say 19909 909, and it's also connecting to X server. And we have more stuff. we have more stuff, and all of a sudden VDA agent is getting really hot. We didn't see that before, but we see it now. So, VDA agent, guess we have to deal with that. So we have a stream connect also here. Oh, this self. And we have the stream connect to X server. And then we have a VD agent actually looking at the process state. And I'll just grab that from someone else who does also read process state here. Copy this. Where is VD agent? Because it's probably similar. Then just put that in here, and it's, let's see what it is exactly. So here we have that searching VDA agent process state file there. So that's basically VDA agent, VDA agent, and then that's actually just VD agent, the system service or whatever. Like that. This should be it. And let's just go through this again. Do we have any, by the way, do we have any user AVC denials currently? No. Till and 200 var log messages, and then audit to allow. None. Alright, that looks good. Let's build install. So these are just some bugs that pop up when you boot the system and when you're basically starting over. Let's log off. Oh, we actually are logged off. So that's nice. So I guess our dir is empty. Yep, it is. Alright, so let's log in. Let's see what we have. No pop-ups currently, but there was this old one. All right. Seems I lost connection or something. Yep, system is hanging. Gotta be kidding me. Okay, so the system is hanging. That's not nice. That's not nice at all. Yeah, not responding, and I noticed. So let's first Fedora 18. Sit down. But it can't. Not getting any signal through. So that's going to be a hard reset. Holy moly. Okay, this is going to be a hard reset, unfortunately. Timed out, error shutting down domain, timed out during operation. Cannot acquire straight state change log, yeah. I wonder why this probably might actually be related to no, it doesn't seem to be related, at least not to as a Linux, but might be related to the fact that I changed some stuff. So I'm gonna force off. I have no other option. Well, at least that still works, or at least that works. How unfortunate. So that means I hope this will not happen too often. There's still bugs there. Let's just try this in the host. I'm not sure if that's related, but somehow it failed to send a signal. Now it's going to have to do some FSCK. Nasty. Nasty. Yeah, it's going to have to be doing some restoring of file system if that's even possible. hope it didn't mess with my content. Let's have a look at VDA, the VD. See if it's all still there. So what was the stuff that we added later on? Yeah, that seems to be there. So it seems that let's remove this one. Yeah, right. So that's not nice. It's not nice at all. Oh, and it's ouch. Jesus. What a mess. I hope that doesn't happen too often. Okay, kill all. No, well, I don't have to worry about that, but I do have to worry about clear my login. User shell and also lsrzdemp. Actually not, I don't have to worry about that either, but we'll see, because it cleared temp. Yeah. Okay. No. Our search. MACTS 9. Add it to allow. Let. So just to be certain, I put the host in permissive mode, not the guest. So that I can be sure that SELinux isn't blocking anything on the host. Am I hanging again? You gotta be kidding me. No, I'm not hanging. This has a lot to search, I guess. And a lot of this stuff is not related. We have some stuff here. So we need to take care of that ASAP. So PD agent. And I'll just put it in here for a while. So we have this There's a search home there. Get attribute. Search. Seems to be wanting to read the password file, so that's actually get attribute. Open read. This is in a force mode, so it's just showing you the first. The Unix datagram socket connect, we already had that one. Didn't we? Yep, we did. For the agent stream connecting to. Yeah, we already had that one. And this. It's the environment. Let's just get attribute and search there. And so it wants to basically send syslog messages. So we'll have to look that up. And I'll just open up IDE and see what's all. Actually, I can't. I really need to just do this the hard way, because we're using nowadays a journal which doesn't actually go via okay. Save and exit. See if it builds. Install it. And then also my XDM PP. I hope it doesn't happen too often, else I'm going to have to go back to root, to running the guest's root. Okay, so now let's see what we have. We're going to look for 30, 930, trying to get something at least a little bit clean, but we're in enforcing mode currently, so well, we need to stay in enforcing mode for a while. It's going to take a while. Just as long as it doesn't crash. It already did. Jesus. It already did crash. Holy moly. So I'm going to have to basically, I wonder why this is. I'm going to try it once more, and then also, and then basically I'm going to put the host in enforcing mode, because it's obviously not the host. And now I'm going to basically shut this, force it off forcibly again. I'm going to try the guest in permissive mode. Although I just don't see how logging in as a unprivileged user can crash the whole system. Sick term, cannot send a termination signal. Terminate signal. I think it's this buggy with regard to it running in an unprivileged process. And that's very unfortunate. Okay. This is not good for my hard disk on the guest. Fleet's not corrupting. Recovering, I know. Clearing orphan in home. Okay, so first thing I'm gonna do is get into permissive mode. Setting 4.0, although I'm pretty sure this is unrelated. At least if that could cause a total system crash, then there's something terribly wrong. This will take a while, just to make sure that it doesn't crash. Hasn't crashed so far. And if it does crash in permissive mode, then I just need to run the guest's route, unfortunately. And that's basically all due to that PCI pass-through thing that I did. I basically just forwarded my second network interface to the guest so that I can have a full speed network on my guest. Thank you. takes a long time. There's a lot of log messages, of course. Because I put it with SEMAJOBDB. So we have, this is all, okay, we have here. So this at least helps me find some stuff. DSAT D, self-netlink socket. CD my login user, nano my login user TE, and then DSAT D, and then it's netlink. Self netlink here, and I'll just copy this here for now, guys. And it's actually read, and this is probably also related to sending syslog messages in the new style. We have TR store actually adding a name, so this is interesting. We have VDA agent searching, so we need to look at into this a little later. This is allowed. Oh, it's actually sending to kernel. This is also related to syslog. Copy that. This is also related. Paste that in. This is the new style, sending to journal D instead of the old syslog style. Where were we? Oh yeah, it's needing to basically search user home doors. So that, let's add this below this one, and let's get that so we can search. This is loud, and here we have reading foreign T file. Let's just make that get attribute, read, and open. Okay, that should be that. This is allowed. Okay, so let's just grab TR store and see what's grab TR store, what it's trying to create. No, it's still running. It has a lot of stuff to go through. This is what we're needing here. So it's creating a track, the tracker there in the config. In the config home teeter. So tracker store is tracker config. So let's have a look. because I know that something has already permissions to create it, so tr minor fs might actually already be allowed to do that. Let's see. Yeah, this is not related to config. Okay, tr store. Something is already allowed to create it. Then it's creating that tracker there. And it's called TR minor. Config home tree, and then basically a create. Yeah, that's basically what it does. Tracker in config. Let's save this before stuff might hang. And then go back and then again go to tr minor fs tr minor. And now something is creating it. Yeah, here it is. Alright, so it's basically a race between the two. Whoever gets there first gets to create it. CD my login user. And we need to add a class there. KU event. And it's KU event. U event. And then it's blabbing about which permission read. And I'm going to allow eventually, I'm going to allow each one of them. Because that KU event stuff is related to logging. So basically everyone needs to be able to read it. If you look here, for example, let's see if we can find some pattern here. And the strange thing is I can't find that pattern. shell here. So it's the shell login, devlog t. Just pretty darn sure that this is related to login, but I can't make any assumptions, so just need to do that same stuff, and this does actually can be sure that this is just the there's no devlog here. Yeah, not yet. I'm just overlooking it. Alright, just save this. Would be weird if you'd be able to basically crash the server because it's not able to now we get this again, it takes a long time. But we need to do that because we want to see if anything in the meanwhile was added. Not sure why people outside are doing what they are doing. We're not hanging. I was just checking. Yet. Knock on wood. Okay. What do we have? What do we have that we can possibly just add? That seems to be it so far. So let's see if we're clean at 5.4. and just let try to log in. And then walk through these again. And the shitty thing is that basically what we need to do is do this all across the board. Pools, audio, home, T, link, file. So remove name, rename and link. Remove name, rename and link. Rename and link. Remove name. Rename and link. Remove name. Name and link. Remove name. Save and exit. So we did that. And then we have TR store writing to data and T file. TR store. Right to data on T. Right. And we have VDA agent reading XCG V. The agent and this will also require some more config home T. You should be able to search that there, search there. The attribute, because else you can't get to that. Save that. What else do we have? get attributes of file. Crying out loud. Feed the agents. And that's a process state file here. Get attribute. Save and exit. Let's hit make as a module. So the weird thing is that actually a unprivileged user can actually crash the system. Log off. At least that's what it seems. Either that or VDA agent can do that. Kill all. You. My login user. Clear my login user shell ls all z temp rm rf temp and then again do this one, takes a long time again. Oh, that it's not that much. See if we have anything that we didn't have before by shutting down. We have Unifedogram socket right here. A lot of VDE agents currently. Datagram sockets. Right. That's just bad news that you are able to crash the whole system by just with just an unprivileged user. That's just bad news. At least that's what I think. I'm not 100% sure, but that's what I think. 10.03. Are we clear? We're clear. Let's log in. Do we have nothing? That sucks. That means that we're going to have to go back to enforcing mode and risk crashes again. Send force one. Make sure we clear. Let's see if we have anything related to logging off. Doesn't seem to be. Okay, now let's see if we have anything at all. No. Log in. And hope we don't crash. No agency denials at all. That doesn't make sense. Basically, this is a board applet trying to execute a board program. It's RDB, it's trying to execute something. What is trying to execute? Oh right, MCPP, and this should be just allowed. Oh no, we soundly denied that. Question is, should we? So we're going to change this. I might have already. We're going to change that. And now we're going to, after this, if this succeeds, we're going to reboot and try this all over again from forcing mode. And we did clear the home, the my login user. No, we didn't. So we need to do that first. Kill all. Clear. And then ls all temp. Rm rf temp. This one. And then we're going to basically shut down, halt now. And it's shutting down. Okay, so we'll leave it at that for this chapter. Was some debugging stuff going on. Yeah, see you next chapter.